Maryland State Correctional Facility for Women, Baltimore County Branch, has undergone a facelift. Cells are white and ungraffitied, room-like, surprisingly airy. This is where I must spend the next year eating slop from tin trays, facing women much tougher than I am, finding out if I am brave. Though I do not know what I took, I know I took something. On exercise day, walk the streets of the city you grew up in my case, D.C., from pillar to post, Adams Morgan to Anacostia, Shaw to Southwest, Logan to Chevy Chase Circles, recalling every misbegotten everything, lamenting, repenting. How my parents keen and weep, scheme to spring me, intercept me at corners with bus tokens, pass keys, files baked in cakes. Komunyaka the poet says, don't write what you know, write what you are willing to discover. So I will spend this year, these long days, meditating on what I am accused of. In the white rooms, city streets, communal showers, mess hall, where all about me sin and not sin is scraped off tin trays into oversized things. All that excess, scraped off and rinsed away. Opiate. A date with Michael Jordan proves he is a true gentleman. Arrives smiling, bearing a bouquet of red carnations, driving a modest sports car in a sober but stylish navy blue suit. He grins that grin. Hello, Michael Jordan. Then off you go. Have your date, then have lovely safe sex. After which you remember you are married. You don't know Michael Jordan, even though he's your age mate and lumbers off the championship court nowadays, looking much like you do after nursing your newborn at 4 in the morning. Blue night after inky blue night. Michael Jordan is the opiate of the masses, comes a voice at the end of the dream. Perhaps John Cameron Swayze or James Earl Jones as Darth Vader. Michael Jordan is the opiate of the masses. Opiates are verboten for nursing moms like me. Improbable, ominous, our date was so father knows best, so Mayberry RFD, such a wide, wide grin. I wake to a foghorn. Opiate of the masses, no memory of the feel of his dark and lovely skin. This also feels timely in a different sort of way, or it's fun to, everything just feels so new these days. Hard, but in new ways, not hard in the awful old ways. Soon to be hard in awful new ways, because that's always how things go. I like looking at old things in new contexts. So this is an old poem in a new context. Did President Obama, say it five times a day at least, name someone to the Supreme Court yet? That didn't happen today. Okay. Anyway, this is postpartum dream number 12, appointment. There's a whole series of these postpartum poems. But the children are now quite large, so. Postpartum dream number 12, appointment. I answered all the Chief Justice's questions impeccably, and it wasn't very hard. I waited with my father for the phone call. I guess I'll be the first black woman on the Supreme Court if I get this. Damn straight, said my dad. The president appeared on television playing golf and smiling. He has a secret. His secretary phones and asks the question. Maybe I could do it when the baby goes to kindergarten. Maybe I could do it on alternate Mondays. Maybe my baby could gurgle and coo in a pen in my chambers, pulling at the curls on my barrister's wig, spitting up on my black robe. Meanwhile, I'm excited. I turned out to be a good lawyer, the best, just like my dad. Life as dinner party. Tonight is a dinner party gone awry. First, there is not enough food. I've purchased rotisserie chicken for four, made a salad with gorgonzola dressing, but the company keeps coming. My students, invited for Friday, arrive Thursday, dressed to kill, bearing street vendor iris and gold chocolate boxes. They take up all the chairs I have and dig into my chicken. Then my parents arrive with my brother's children and strange uncles I've never met, who wear yellow suits and drive late model Cadillacs. One brings a Smithfield ham, grins spaciously, tells me with a wink that it's pre-sliced. Then Amy Capolazzo calls Amy, big bad Italian girl, ex-object of my affections. Ciao, Bella, she says. Who's here and who's fabulous? And she's on her way, bringing peppercorn pate. Here is my motley life at this mismatched dinner table. Mike Tyson's on TV and George Foreman knocks him out. KO, shouts the yellow-suited uncle. But somehow there is plenty to eat. We find more chairs. La Donna Capilazzo arrives, looking smashing, chattering into her tiny cell phone. And finally, finally you come, as you always do, bearing coconut sorbet packed in tiny cocoa shells. Enough for everyone, extra for me. So cool, so pure, so white, so sweet. Emancipation, so we're out of the dream zone now.